care today we're gonna be doing banana jigs. I don't have all the hooks, so I think I'm only gonna be making the half ounce and 5/8 ounce. When I get the other hooks, I start making other ones. The ones that I have, they're not strong enough. And you need strong hooks for these blackfish. I'll use the eagle claw hooks. Let it cool off. This gets very hot. Once that's nice and tight still there, you know you're good to go. Nice and sealed. The respirator. And all this goes right back in the pot. Nothing goes to waste. Okay, we did 3/8 of an ounce and 1/2 ounce banana jigs. Now we're gonna do 2 and 2.5 ounce. Until I get the hooks for the 3 ounce. Too many of those trees, they look very heavy, but you go on the boat, you go deep sea, you want them heavy. that's what I'm gonna do for now. Get back at you. The bigger ones are easy to clean than the smaller ones. I got a 2 ounce banana head jig right there. And this is a 3. So when you go deep sea, you wanna get caught out there with a strong current, 170, 80, 90 feet, and you got a half an ounce. It ain't gonna go down. There you go. Alright, now we're gonna be doing some 2, 3, 4, and 5 ounce sinkers. The easiest and the best thing to do to save some money. In the long run, you're gonna be saving a lot of money. Especially like me, I lose a lot of sinkers. Get snagged a lot. Let that bad boy cool off. Comes off as one piece. Boy, that baby's hot. There you go. We got 2, 3, 4, 5 ounces. All that leg gets put right back in the pot. Alright, this is it for now. I'll get back at you when I powder paint the banana jig heads. Okay, here we go. We're gonna powder paint some banana jig heads. I made a few of them. So let's see where we go with. Baby bass green. Let's try this out. Probably throw it a little black. And some red. Let's start with the big ones. This 2.5 ounces. The bigger they are, the little longer it takes, but you're gonna see the shine on it. So a good 20, 25 seconds. Get it nice and heated, like that you get a good coat out of it. And You can always dip it the second time, but you really don't want that. Just add another layer of paint. Opening day for Blackfish, October 15th. We did some catch and release. There's some nice ones out there. We're gonna get ready. Baby bass green, but I want to throw some black on that. Good thing about this, long as you got the colors, be creative, you make your own colors. These things are expensive. It's getting hot, so I'm holding on to the pliers. To the side. Let's go with a yellow chartreuse. Dip it again, then grab it all. Yellow chartreuse, banana jig head. Alright, try a smaller one. Let's try a dragon blue. These are smaller, so they heat up quicker. dragonfly. Dragonfly, banana jigger. Pumpkin brown. I'm saying you can always add a little extra color so you can make them half and half. Right now I'm trying to just get as many as I can, as quick as I can in one video. Pumpkin brown, but I'm gonna add some colors to this. Add a little black to it. You didn't get enough, you can always go back and just add some more, which I'm gonna do right now. Pumpkin brown with black and baby bass green. Chartreuse green. Make sure you get open up the eye later on. gonna be hard. Green chartreuse. Let's try 2 ounces. I got glitter there too, you could always add glitter. Still learning on this. I started this hobby during the pandemic. I was bored, I needed something to do. Started doing bucktail jigs, bucktail minnows. I got so much supply, so I might as well keep doing what I need. I go through it, me and my friends go through a whole bunch of them. And these things can get pricey, so in the long run, it pays for itself. You could even come out with some color that not even out there. Flaming red. I'm gonna get some all the way to the end, so I don't wanna dip it again. Flaming red. Bright green. Once you keep shaking it, it gets nice and sore, turns it into quicksand. You need to make sure it's nice and fluffy when you dip it in there. You can go as far as you have to. Make sure you cover the whole thing. This is bright green. Oh, I like this one. After I paint them all, then I put them in the toaster oven for about another 15-20 minutes. But that's before. First, I have to put the clear coat on it. Bright green. What we have here? Candy raspberry. Candy raspberry. Nice and fluffy. We'll do a small one. So that's a little bottle. My heating gun sounds like it's about to go. That's pretty. Okay. Whew. Look at that. Candy raspberry. That's real pretty. Flaming red. This is what? Flaming red. Flame red. How is the night, huh? Flaming red. Flaming red. Yellow chartreuse. I don't remember if I did a yellow chartreuse already, but yes, I did. Well, I guess I have to. Two bottles, that's what I'm saying. chartreuse, but none of that. Well, we have here red, pink pearl. Pink pearl. Oh, that's nice. So I'm just doing one basic color in it, but you can always add more to it. You always could come back to the jig head, warm it up a little bit, and just add whatever color you want to it before putting the clear coat on it or putting it in the toaster oven. Pearl.